was great talk that you gave today. Thank you very much. I was very encaptured by everything that you were discussing. And I thought we would kick it off with diving a little bit more into how you came to meet Ken and the thought process behind developing this ERAS protocol.
Right. Well, I had known Ken Fearon from the literature before I met him. He is simply an outstanding clinical researcher, and I read several of his papers, and I admired all the work that he'd been doing. And it just so happened that we were lecturing in the same session, at the same conference, back to back. And so here I was stepping into my seat right in front of the stage, and here was this small Scottish red-haired gentleman sitting right beside me, Ken Fearon. I had no idea what it looked like, but we instantly hit it off, if I put it that way. So right after our talks, we went to the pub and start talking, and very quickly came around to, well, there's nothing out there. We have to do something about it, and that's how it all started.
And you mentioned how the different elements, you know, anesthesiologists versus surgeons versus anesthesiologists, kind of work in their own silos,
right?
And never really communicated. Mm-hmm. What was your initial? How did you initially come about thinking of that as being a potential cause?
Well, that developed over time, I would say, and you know, you realize that there are so many different things that you can do as a surgeon that would make it more difficult for the anesthesiologist once you start thinking about it. But nobody really had beforehand. And the same thing for them. Then we realized if we're ever going to put this together and make it smooth for the patient all the way through and reduce, really what it is all about reducing the stress of surgery and maintain homeostasis as normal as possible all the way through. Then you need to have everybody sit around and make the choices that actually fit with that. Not something that they're used to doing, but maybe change something so that it actually works better in the overall run for the patient.
Sure. And so you developed the ERAS protocol.
Yeah.
Which you mentioned was about 10 years ago now, correct? Or in 2010?
Yeah, well, we started implementing it in 2010. But the publication was more than 10 years ago, actually.
And so throughout this implementation process, how have you seen adoption? Has it been a challenge? Has it been something that has been picked up easily, or has it really taken time to sit?
Invite hospitals. We welcome hospitals to come and join these implementation training programs. And we have expert teams that run them for them. And so we have several teams come together at the same time, several hospitals. And if they just get those teams up and running, they get the results. Because it's all about sitting there and looking at what are we doing and what we actually add, which I didn't have much time to talk about. We help people see what they're doing. So we're using some IT to help people see what they're actually up to. And once they see it, of course, they see where to make the changes. And then, you know, how do we do that? Well, that depends on how the overall picture looks like. And they each sort of start doing these things while we're coaching them to make those changes. And by having several teams together at the same time in a series of workshops, they also show progression over time. So one or two of these teams usually kick off and shoot away, make the changes, and get the results. You know, it's very simple in the end, because the more things you do right, the better your outcomes are going to be.
Sure. And then another question on adoption, you know, health systems in the United States versus globally. You know, some are more focused from a government standpoint versus on individual hospitals. So has the approach to adoption or getting it into specific hospitals differed depending on where you're looking?
Not really, actually. We've trained private hospitals in some countries. We've trained a lot of government-run hospitals. We do the same thing. I think the bottom line is that people who are in healthcare are there to help others. Mm-hmm. So if you can help them do that, they'll get it done. And it has to happen on the floor. See, this is not something you can tell people go home and do. You got to help them actually get it done on the floor in every single place.
Sure.
See?
Yeah. And for everyone who watched your talk today across the world, is there one specific message that you hope they take away from this and move forward with?
Well, I hope they got the message that if we do things a little bit differently, we can achieve fantastic results. This is a revolution. There's nothing else out there that would reduce complications by up to 50%. It's magic, really. And it's so simple.
Great. Ollie, thank you for your talk today.
Thank you.